All right, what do we got here? Keepable hand. I can get green white off Verdant Catacombs, and I can cast Path or Dismember on turn one, followed by Goyf, followed by potentially Liliana. Or I can just cast a Brook to Can turn two. So the question is, do I kill a turn one Wild Nacatl? Seems pretty clear that I do. Especially if it's going to deal three, dismembering it and taking less is probably good. I don't really want a Path on turn one, just because sometimes that deck keeps really land-light hands. And in those circumstances, I think accelerating them out early is bad. Especially since, given that how few lands I have in my hand, I think I'm going to end up paying 4 life for Dismember one of these turns anyway. So, might as well do it now. Monastery, Swift Spear, I guess. I think in response, I kill the Nacatl. This way, if worse comes to worst, and he's got double mutagenic growth or some nonsense like that, or even just path his own Nacatl in response, I don't get hit by a giant Monastery, Swift Spear. Alright. Taking one. And that's just tough. If I play Tarmogoyf and it gets path, that's annoying, but I guess it's getting path then. You know, I actually think I could just get forest here, because that way, because I drew this during Wildwood, I know I'm going to have white regardless, which means that next turn I can still just cast a Replicate, play Stirring Wildwood, and then start playing white spells. I don't really want to pay extra life for it, for white mana. So I like just playing Goyf here. The other thing is, mutagenic growth, I assume, is worse after board, because you expect maybe more removal. Though, if you see an Obstinate Baleless, that's not necessarily true. Foil Path to Exile, how lucky. Alright. Yeah. And it's not great getting past, but I get to kill a bunch of things next turn, and I get a white source off it, which is kind of nice. Thing is, I really didn't want to use Abrupt Decay on Wild Nacatl instead of Tarmogoyf's, and I wanted to take the opportunity to try to have two blockers instead of just one. Alright. I'm going to pass, and I'm probably just decaying the Nacatl and taking one off Monastery Swift Spear and saving Path for a potential Tarmogoyf. Is that accurate? I think I actually... Well, he's stuck on two lands. Yeah, I don't really want a Path here. I'll take my one. He's got four cards in hand. Here's a Tarmogoyf. That's fine. I don't need to path in a turn either. I don't think it helps me play Lingering Souls here. Pass. Really need to get a second black. I mean, I thought I was supposed to get white off the path. Maybe I was supposed to get black. I don't know. It felt like this is better. All right. I'm going to go for a double block on the Swift Spear. I don't really care too much if he's got a burn spell, because I can splash it back and do it again next turn. Alright. Well, I'm going to path the Tarmogoyf, because I'm clearly not taking millions of damage off Tarmogoyf. And hopefully I draw black mana. Ideally basic swamp. Something that makes me not take damage. That would be nice. I'm at 5 versus 3 cards in hand. Can't love this situation. Cut on a siege right now. Actually, that's pretty good. Tarmogoyf, Lingering Souls. And hopefully, now I've got room to breathe here. And if I get past, I guess I can get another swamp, which is kind of nice. Geist of St. Traft is actually not the worst thing in the world for me. I mean, it's obviously a huge threat, but because of the spirit tokens, I can block the Geist with Tarmogoyf and chump the Angel with a spirit token. Gets me out of that situation fairly well. So I've got Stirring Wildwood, which eventually could be relevant. And I've got a lot of Lilianas, so if I draw black mana, I can start using Liliana's abilities. As opposed to looking at three Lilianas in my hand, they're not doing anything. So what could Pat have here? He could have Mutagenic Growth, which would make his Monstrous Suspir 4-5. Okay, he's drawn a land, and I imagine there's a Geist... Nope, Tarmogoyf fighting there. All right. Land or spell? Alright, I'll accept a siege right now. Probably passing, because I don't know what I'm going to have available to block with, but I want to set up some nice double blocks here. But I wouldn't mind another siege rhino. In fact, if I could just draw some, three more siege rhinos, I think I'd be in pretty good shape. though black mana still would not be bad. So if just Tarmogoyf attacks, I can like double block and then path happens and they bounce and you bolt. So maybe I put one spirit in and then you path the Goyf. Yeah, this all seems fine to me. So it's just instance creatures and lands in the graveyards right now, no sorceries. The good thing about that is they Goyf can't grow instant speed anymore. You can play a sorcery to make it grow, but we'll know about that before combat happens. So I don't mind this position too much, especially given my hand is actually full of spells, so eventually I will draw something. I think I actually hit with one of the spirits here. Because now I have Stirring Wildwood up, I have additional blockers. I could attack with the Siege Rhino. I'm just worried about, yeah, like a Mutagenic Growth. He doesn't, or a Snapcaster Mage, like Snapcaster Path, Snapcaster Bolt. Yeah, here it comes. I imagine it's Path. The good thing is that gets me to casting Liliana, so Pat may not be aware that is an issue for me. Right. Swamp, my last basic. So now, if everything attacks, probably put like Wildwood on Swift Spear, Goyf on Goyf, Spirit on Snapcaster? No, probably Spirit on Tarmogoyf, Goyf on Snapcaster, Wildwood on Swift Spear. Yeah, I like those blocks. Then I can follow it up with Liliana. Put a pretty high premium on killing my opponent's non-Goyf creatures with combat, because then I get to Liliana mop things up. Mm-hmm. So Goyf can't get bigger. To path, yeah. I'm gonna go for it. I'm not gonna be able to activate this during Wildwood next turn anyway, so I think this is fine. I get to double block now. I don't think I put the spirit tokens in the way. I think I just double block here. Alright. And if he's got a burn spell, then I traded a Goyf for a Goyf and a burn spell, which is a fantastic deal. If he doesn't have a burn spell, if he has a mutagenic growth, still kill his guy. So if he's got mutagenic growth plus a burn spell, that does kill both my creatures, and that's not great for me, but you know, what can you do at that point? I would have expected more attackers potentially there. Alright, and if it's path, it's just a push here. Alright, I don't think I have anything left to get. Yeah, I know. Alright, and if it's path plus like a burn spell, then I lose a Stirring Wildwood, which I wasn't activating anyway, so take that. Looks like he might have to be having second thoughts about killing the Wildwood. It's not a huge threat, but I guess if he thinks I'm just, like, flooded, it could be. The goose is loose. Now what? Now what? Yeah, it's got to actually be Siege Rhino, I think. As nice as it would be to Liliana here, I think I have to cast the Rhino. I guess I could have Liliana and left up Treetop Village as a blocker, but Rhino just dissuades everything from attacking, and Liliana just kills a Swift Spear or a Snapcaster Mage, neither of which are really doing anything right now. So, if everything attacks here, I'd probably put a token on the Angel, I'd probably put Geist, or Rhino on Geist, and then a token on Snapcaster, and take a hit from Goyf and Swift Spear. Yeah, that seems reasonable to me. If I get to untap, then I get to cast Liliana and have Treetop up, so that's also fine. Alright, see if anything's coming in. Looks like just the Geist. I'm certainly blocking there, and I think I chump. This sounds to me like he's got another Geist in hand. Because if he had a good combat trick, I think he would have made that attack. He could have attacked with more things. Or it looks like this is just the Bolt. Alright, that's fine too. And no cards in hand. Alright, time to start Liliana-ing. And I'd leave Treetop up here. I'm at 11. Alright. This eats like a Swift Spear. Or, yeah, probably a Snapcaster Mage. And then I don't think I pay the life because right now Treetop is fine. So my plan now is if Goyf comes in, I get to double block Goyf with Treetop and Spirit Token. And so Spirit gets through. And I'm actually okay with that. These main lines are being really, really good this game. They've certainly been cards. Alright, just Goyf coming in? I can handle that. And another reason that I'm very willing to double block here, even though, you know, a trick could happen, is that like, I'm not activating both these lands in the same turn anyway, pretty much, so I think doing this is fine. Bolt Liliana, Goyf becomes a 4-5. Gross. Oh no, we traded. Great! And he plays a spell. Is it a Geist of St. Traft? Well, that card is good. I think actually just plus one, discarding Thoughtseize and pass the turn, because now Stirring Wildwood can block Geist of St. Traft. And Spirit Token can block either Angel or Swift Spear, depending on what's coming in here. And then if nothing else happens, I get to minus Liliana, then play second Liliana and minus Liliana. So I kind of like that too. Thoughtseize is pretty good right there, though I actually would have much, much rather had Dark Confidant than just discard an excess Liliana here, but what can you do? Alright. Are we getting attacked here? It's kind of bad to not attack, in the sense that, like, a Planeswalker's, you know, doing its thing, but Darmogoyf's pretty good. Ooh, that wasn't bad. Alright. Eat a creature. That would be Monstrous of Spear, by the way. Followed by eat a creature. Followed by Tarmogoyf. Kind of assume it's Geist getting devoured here. Just because it doesn't match up well against Stirring Wildwood. Alright, and I actually think I pass here. One of the reasons to pass is that if he draws a Lightning Bolt and attacks with Goyf and I block with just Goyf, that's not good. Whereas if he drew a Bolt now, I get to get value. I don't need this Twilight Mire, I don't think. Well, what could the card be that I'd care about? If it's a land, I don't care. But you know, if it's a land, I'm just winning this game right now, so it is a land. Alright. I'll keep this Liliana. I mean, I guess I don't literally win the game this instant, but I'm not going to lose the game with him at 1 versus my Goyf Bird Token and Stirring Wildwood here, so bam. Outplayed him very severely there, getting stuck on one land in the other game, but hey, I got a match.